This is a critical time, a time when we face the challenge of shaping a vision to guide the growth of our cities into a future of fairness, opportunity, and equity.
The only way you can be more efficient, the only way you can be a better place for growth, job development, quality of life, is if in fact you are a just city.
Cities don't compete globally, metros do. And so we have a big competition within the United States. Who will create a cohesive, intentional, purposeful, deliberate metropolitan strategy?
None of the communities south of Camden wanted this rail line because they said all the crime from Camden's gone. Now, I mean, how many robbers stop for get the train in the schedule? You know, I'm sorry, they've got to wait and get out. It was ridiculous. There was enormous pushback. Now that rail line is full. What's happened is that suburbs along the line, the businesses, the property values have gone up. The businesses are doing more business.
All these cities all around the world, you know what they got in common? Homeless. Every one of them got homeless.
And I mean, especially, I'm not going to lie, like, I look at Latinos in this country, it's like, you know, like, we're about to be the majority in, like, 2 weeks.
First of all, I'm from Brooklyn, but saying me personally, I come from a culture and an art form that wouldn't exist without cities, you feel me? So that's why I'm here with y'all. Y'all talking about justice, I'm going to tell y'all about justice.
If we don't pay attention to a poor child's education, their housing, how their parents might be able to get to all of those pieces, we're going to fail. This is where I think foundations have an enormous role in ensuring that there is a pressure and an institutionalization of these kind of these partnerships.
I am now helping Obama meet his import goal of doubling exports because Oakland is the only port that exports more than imports. And I'm more likely to get investments from a Chinese developer in some of these tougher parts of Oakland than I am from American investors.
For the first time in anybody's memory, the Secretary of Transportation meets with the Secretary of HUD, meets with the Secretary or the Administrator of the EPA every several weeks, every 3 or 4 weeks, so that if you're applying for $500 million for transportation, you better have affordable housing around your light rail stop. They're running government like a business.
I'm going to ask for the first question from Bruce Katz.
Okay, well, I was in the middle of a tweet. So, so you just...
It seems to me that there must be innovations that enable excluded communities to actually own and control some of these new forms of green economy opportunities.
The just city becoming more synonymous with the just worker or the just employer. And if so, what's the role of geography in that kind of discussion?
In the 1930s, my dad had no papers, but he had a union defending his rights. And when he came back from the war, there was a GI Bill, which meant that he could buy a house in an inner ring suburb. And he was able to go from being a janitor to being an air conditioner repairman. And we went from being poor to being working class. And I went to decent public schools because we were investing them as a society. And that's the American story.
Cities have to be a part of the revival of the American dream.
When you're mayor, you're in a lot of private rooms, private meetings, where if you don't have inclusion and equality as a part of who you are, then you can easily get away from it. You know, I say all of the time that being mayor is really where hope meets the street.